So now the fact that the level one is done, so we must be like chilling for some time. And yeah, we have full right to do so because we have worked hard. Most of us have worked at least for 500 hours. Some of us have even studied for more than that. We have sacrificed a lot of things to clear this exam. So now we have done our part. So now it's up to CFA Institute to do their part of evaluation. So this is the time that we can have a little bit of chill out feeling. Unless you're taking a level to August exam. If you're taking a level to August exam, how many of you are thinking about level to August exam? I frankly feel that level to August exam, you should not be targeting that unless you have some personal reasons, because there is a level two in November, there's a level two in February 22, which is cheaper as compared to level to August and having more time as compared to level to August. Frankly, level to August is going to be a very, 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 first of all, costly, $300 extra. And secondly, very, very, very like kind of exhaustive. Just that you have taken a level one exam and now if you're going to prepare for level two, August exam, you'll have to start your preparation immediately. You have to stop chilling out. So whatever Netflix, Hotstar, everything has to be put aside and you have to prepare for level two immediately if you're taking a level two August exam, and which obviously I wouldn't recommend you, because you have every bit of a right you deserve to chill out for some time. So, but if you plan for a level to August, then obviously you don't have that luxury of chilling out. So in that case, you'll have to start your preparation immediately for the level to August exam. How many of you are in that category that we want to go for level to August exam, even though it's costly, even though I'm saying, no, I don't want, I'm saying ki, you should not, but still for some reasons might be that you could be. All right, so two students have raised hand. So for this two students, I would be, and I think one is Mansi also. She was going to go for MS Finance, etc. So if you're going to have some plans, because of which November is not possible, then you have to go for an August exam, and then you have to start your preparation immediately, because August ke liye time kitna bacha hai? March, April, May, June, July. 5 months, and then your level to August is there. So you will have to start your preparation immediately if you are planning for level to August. Okay. So one part is that ki now you can chill out. If you're going to take level to November or level to February, you can chill out for some time. Second, when are the results going to be there? Normally it takes around 45 days, around 7 weeks, complete 7 weeks to get the results. So normally the December exam ka result comes at the end of January, June exam ka results comes at the end of July. Normally, when the December and June used to be the exam patterns, the December exam, which used to happen in the first week of December, uska result aata na last week of January mein, and first week of June ka exam ka result used to come at the last week of July. Around 50 days is what the exam results used to take. Obviously, because of the digitalization of the exam, the paper delivery, collating all the papers at one go, at one place, that physical movement of the papers, that time gets saved. So it used to take around 10 days for getting this physical papers at one go. And then they used to scan it through an OMR sheet. So from the OMR sheet, they used to scan. So that particular time gets saved. So I'm expecting around 15 days. Results will be faster by 15 days. So I'm expecting around 30 to 35 days of period of time in which I can expect that the students would be able to get their results. Okay. So last date, I think Sana took the exam on the last date. Sana is there? Sana, if you're there, raise hand, please. Okay. She isn't there. Okay. So Sana had taken the exam on 1st of March. She chose the last slot. The most smart. She took the last slot and it was on 1st of March. So you can count 1st March, say around 30 to 35 days. So I expect the results to be somewhere around 5th April to 10th April. In that period of time, I'm expecting the results. So we are at 9th March. Ek mahina kaafi hai. I mean, minimum 1 month we have for the exam results to come. As of now, they are not given any timeline on the website about the exam results, etc. But I'm expecting it should come around 10th of April. Which means for level 2 November exam, you will be eligible for early bird slot, because level 2 November ka early bird slot for $700 is valid till around 2nd of May. So you will be comfortably able to get your results before that, and you will be able to register for the early bird. Okay, you will have at least around 25-30 days. You can prepare also in that period and then take a call. And then invoice method also is going to be there. So 2nd May ke pehle, you will be able to get your results easily. Are you able to hear me? It's coming out to be stuck or something. Okay. So you will be able to just raise hand if you're able to hear me properly. Yeah, perfect. So you'll be able to get your results way before the early bird deadline of your level 2 exam. Okay, so what you should do, apart from obviously chilling out, what you can do in this period of 1 month. One is that if you are not working, I'm telling you this, if you're not working, you can look at one reading of the business magazines. So look at Business World. It's a good magazine. Economist is a little heavy language or a magazine, but you can have a look at Economist magazine. Daily newspaper, obviously Mint is a paper which I like. Obviously abhi to some online news, so InShorts, etc., that app you can download and try to connect every news that you see, try to connect with whatever we have learned in the CFA level 1 in any of the subject. Okay, and what you should do is whenever you are able to see a news and whenever you are able to connect, this can be connected to what I have learned in the CFA. In that case, just take a snapshot of that, save it somewhere so that before you go for an interview, you should have these points in your mind so that when you speak in the interview, you should be able to connect the news that you have read in the newspaper or in the business channels with what you have learned in the CFA. Okay, so there are many places, few days back, yields in the US were rising and people call it that's the reason for a stock market crash. So there was a connect between that and the stock market crash. As RF increases, the cost of equity will increase, the valuation will go down because of that, and hence probably the stock market prices were crashing. So there was a possible connect with that. So whenever you see news, you should try to have a connect with that news with the theory that we learned in the CFA. The blogs that we were doing in the month of December, they were planned for that only, like Harshad Mehta wala blog, then Lakshmi Vilas wala, Vilas Bank wala blog. So you should understand the way the blogs were made. From that, you should get a connect ki, is tarah se we can connect the practical things with the theory things. So that's one important thing. Obviously, just looking at the news is not good enough because wo to sabko hi dekhta hai. So you should be able to connect the news with the knowledge that you have got in the CFA level 1. Okay, that's one thing. Be it Business World, be it Economist, be it a normal business channel, you should be able in a position to connect the news with the CFA knowledge that you have gained in the level 1. Finance knowledge that you have gained in the CFA level 1. Okay, apart from that, I have conducted 2 financial modeling sessions. Right now, I'm not able to conduct the financial modeling session because of a lot of professional and personal commitment. I'm like a little occupied with that, but I would want you to go through those 2 financial modeling sessions. I'll be sending the links in the group. So in the month of October, I had done that. Some of you might have already attended those sessions. How many attended that financial modeling sessions I conducted? If you're not attended, it's okay. Some of you attended that. Good. So just look at those video recording 2 sessions that I did and try to do it by yourself in your PC. Just don't look at it. I mean, have a look at it on the mobile and then try to do it on your laptop. So you should have your hands on your laptop. So that's the 2 financial modeling sessions that you can have a look at it. And then maybe right now I'm busy with the level 1 May guys, level 2 May guys and level 3 May guys. So after the May exam gets over, I'll surely will get time so we can have more financial modeling sessions planned in the month of May. Apart from that, I'm just talking about those guys who are not having a job right now. So you should look for internship. So whatever internship you're getting, just make sure that it's not a marketing or a sales kind of internship. It should be something related to research kind of internship. So there should be some element of using this in the internship. Just a sales kind of internship wouldn't have any value. It may be a free internship, doesn't matter. What matters is the knowledge that you gain from that internship, because that will be able to put in on your resume and that will help you fetch a good job. Okay, apart from that, if you want to look at level 2 sessions, I will be more than happy to welcome you guys for the level 2 sessions in the month of March. How many are interested in attending level 2 sessions in the month of March? Even though you might be taking your level 2 in November, even though you're taking level 2 November, you're okay to start your level 2 preparations. I'm okay. I'm more than welcome. I will not be charging you fees to attend the lectures. Maybe I'll charge you 500 rupees of fee or something like that as a token to attend the lectures in March. And actual fees would be available. You will have to pay only after you clear your level 1. Okay, so if you are interested in level two sessions, just let me know. I'll send you the, or what I'll do, I'll put the level two links in the meeting IDs in the your group, so that you'll be able to attend those level two sessions. Level two ka jo notes hai, I'll forward that in the group so that you'll be able to see the syllabus of level two. And I will send you a video recording about how syllabus of level two is there and how is level two different from level one. That briefing I'll give it to you. So either I'll take it live like this, or I'll send you a video recording where you'll get a complete idea that how is level two different than level one. Just to give one perspective, level two is the toughest level of CFA. Yes, you heard it right. Level two is the toughest level of CFA. Level three is easier than level two. So level two is the toughest level of the CFA exam, and hence requires your maximum efforts in the level two. Level one ke liye, if you have spent around 500, 550, 600 hours, for level two, it would require at least 750 hours. It is vast as well as it is in depth. Everything that you had seen in level one, now in the level two, you will go in the microscopic view of that. Be it fixed income valuation, be it equity valuation, be it derivative valuation, you'll be going into the depth of that. In level one, you saw in derivatives binomial, here you will see level two Black-Scholes-Merton. In level one equity, you saw dividend discount model. Now in level two, you'll see free cash flow model, residual income model. You will see the private company valuations. You'll see all the things in the detail. Okay. The only good thing that I can talk about level two is that the engineers will like FRA. I repeat, engineers and the science background students who hated FRA in level one, they will love FRA in level two, because it's now just around 5% accounts and all 95% demark. So it's going to be all brain related work related to the FRA for level two. This will be a very, very kind of annoying things for the commerce guys, because they had a competitive advantage over the BMS finance guys, the science background students. That level one kajo account said that they FRA 15% was like, this is our master stroke. But now that will not be there in level two. Level two FRA is going to be more enjoyed by the engineers and the science background students rather than the commerce background students. So bad news for commerce background students and good news for the engineers. One kind of a bad news for everyone, the level two cons is a hell. I repeat, the level two cons is a hell. The level two cons, which was enjoyed by the engineers and the science background students, and it was like annoying for the level one commerce kind of students. Now the level two cons is going to be annoying for both categories. Both are going to equally hate that, because it's you'll get to know it about why is it. So it's more about a little bit of by-hearting of a lot of names. To give you a few examples, conditional heteroscedasticity, multicollinearity, Breisch-Pagan test. Okay, so Durbin-Watson test. You have to remember these names. So you understand. I mean, those who like to remember, it's your cup of tea now. So if you like to remember a lot of names, then it's going to be a field that you will enjoy. I am not that kind of thing that who wants to remember a lot of names. So in that case, I would, arch model, etc. So if you like to remember a lot of names, level two cons, you'll enjoy it. Okay, so that's about level two. More details of level two, I'll be putting out in the group. So I'll repeat, one, ek to chill karo. Achha kasa time aapne spend kiya exam ke liye, so one, chill it. And in that chilling period, spend 1 or 2 hours in looking at the business news. Business news matlab ye nahi hai ki kaunsa stock upar ja raha hai, kaunsa stock niche aa raha hai. That is not business news. Business news means ki which company is acquiring another company, what is the valuation that they are looking at, what is happening in a particular sector. Say gas prices are rising. So something where you can talk about. Ye nahi ki stock price upar gaya, stock price niche aaya. That is not a business news. That is a stock market news. So for the interview perspective, you should need to equip yourself with what is happening in the industry. Basically, you can look at the names of the CEO of the company. At least you should know CEO and MD of the company or founder of the companies. So if I ask you who is a Tata Motors CEO, you should be able to name that. So just have a general knowledge of the CEOs of the Nifty companies and the founder of the Nifty companies. So at least we'll get your general knowledge to that level, at least basics. Apart from that, financial modeling sessions and connecting the business news with the knowledge that you have learned in the CFA exam. apart from this, there's one thing that you can do in case you are not working right now, which is taking the NCFM exams, the NSE wala NCFM ka exams, maybe 1-2 maximum. Why so? Because CFA, although has a very, very, very good value and good knowledge of finance that you got from the CFA, but still it's not Indianized. It's a globalized exam. It's not an Indianized exam. So maybe some jobs may require you to know the Indianized. For example, what is the lot size of Nifty? What is the circuit level of each stock? So these are the things that you will get from the NCFM course. So NCFM ka few modules, I'll tell you which modules you can look at it. And I'll send you the links of those modules. So it cost around 2000 rupees for one module. Don't spend a lot of money. Maybe go for two modules. In this 1 month, maybe you can prepare yourself for that NCFM and get your two modules clear in this period of 1 month. Don't spend a lot of money on that. It is a bullshit course, but still, rather than not having it, it's better to have it. I mean, maybe some jobs may require it. So if you can spend 4,000 rupees and do away with this NCFM course and just put it on your resume, it could give you a kind of advantage, not a great advantage, but not having could be a disadvantage. Having may not be an advantage, but not having could be a disadvantage. So get the NCFM done in this period. So one, chill out. Second, NCFM. Third, financial modeling. Fourth, business news and connecting that with the theory. This is what I can believe. And fifth, if you have desire, level two lectures. I'm okay. I'm open for the doubts. Well, anything that you want to ask for next 5-10 minutes, I'm open for the doubts because I have 915K about the question bank solving session. Remember our old golden days of question bank solving session. So I have it for the mail guys now. So any questions that you want to ask, what if I should do like this, I should do like this. Yes, Shreya. So Shreya, did you identify those 20 questions which are not going to be graded? Shreya?
Hi, sir. Yeah. No.
Okay, by the way, for those who aren't aware about it, so let me just put it and then I'll come back to Shreya. So the 180 question that you attempted, was me say 20 questions will not be graded. I don't know how many of you were not aware about it. And out of 180 questions that you attempted, 20 questions will not be graded. How many of you are not aware about it? Okay, around 8 of you are not aware about it. I deliberately didn't mention it out because the point is that you don't know which 20 questions are these which are not going to be evaluated. They will be randomly put into the 180 questions and it was some nonsense thing. I mean, I disagree. I agree with this policy that you are going to evaluate them only on the 160 basis and they're going to take 180 exam and 20 questions are going to be just for time pass. I don't agree with the policy of CFA, but who am I? I mean, okay, I just can express my opinion, but I can't do anything about that. But no one can identify those 20 questions. And Shreya was actually was the student who was putting across this. And some of you may remember, I told Kitiki, no more discussion about those 20 questions. Fine. Yeah, Shreya, go on. Yeah, Shreya, go on, please. All right, Amit. Shreya, Amit, am I audible? Am I audible, guys? Raise hand, please. Okay, I'm audible.
Hello.
Yeah, Shreya, go on. Okay, maybe you can put your question in the Q&A. So where do I access the blog? Shashank, it's there on the website. So I'll put the link of the website for the blog. So you can see those blogs on the website. Nilesh, should we learn programming? Absolutely no. You should not spend your time into learning of the financial languages. Basic Excel is the must. You don't need to spend time and the money on learning the Python and the SQL and the SAS, etc. Not required. If it is required for a specific job, they will train you for that. Okay, so don't spend a lot of money on the Python, SAS and SQL, etc. They are very, very expensive courses. So do not spend time and the money on that. And finance-related courses, if they are like cheaper, then go for it. I mean, I've seen like few institutions giving a placement guarantee and charging a bomb fees. I can't name them right now, but there are like a lot of institutions who charge a bomb fees and give a placement guarantee. But that's really not worth. I mean, after level one, it's kind of guaranteed that you are going to get a job. You don't need a placement guarantee to come from any financial institution to get placed. You are going to get placed. So you don't need to spend a bomb amount just to get a placement guarantee. So spend for the knowledge, don't spend for the placement guarantee. Yeah, I mean, you guys have put it properly in the chat section. I can't take the name. So Darshan has put it properly in the chat section. Darshan can put it to all the attendees, actually. So I can't take the names of those institutions who give the placement guarantee and they charge bomb. I mean, I've seen one particular, I shouldn't call that an institute. I should call it as a company. One particular company charging a X amount for knowledge. And then if you get placed, you will have to pay 50,000 extra. So if we place you, you have to pay 50,000 extra. I mean, that's bloody hell. I mean, you are going to get placed after level. You don't have to pay 50,000 to get placed. And that to this layer saying ki, we guaranteed, but if you get placed, then you have to pay 50,000. So that's bullshit. I mean, don't spend money on the placement guarantee. Spend money on the knowledge and discuss with me. And you can always just say, ki, is this course worth? I'll talk about it. But frankly, I mean, no course is better than level two. You are going to spend a lot of time and money also. $700 is a huge money that you're going to spend on the level two. Yes, Shreya.
So, sir, I wanted to ask about the 20 questions thing. So, frankly, I didn't know it till today.
I mean, it's okay. I mean, let's leave it to the CF Institute because we don't know which 20 questions were this and it's done.
So, isn't it kind of, I mean, vague because if they omit the easy questions, like the questions which are correct from our front, and they
that's
just
what I'm
consider
saying.
The
it
ones.
Complete, I mean, it's completely fair playing field to everyone. So basically, they had planted those 20 questions to everyone, and they would be not evaluating those 20 questions for everyone. So don't worry about it.
Okay, okay.
Yes, Karthik.
Hi, sir. Actually, I wanted to ask you about level two. Is it possible to, you know, clear level two in November while working, or should I play it safe and sit for
If you could manage 700 hours, then it's possible. I think you will be able
to. So, sir, I can manage 2 hours a day.
And weekends?
On weekends, I can, besides classes, I can give 3 hours.
So, if you can manage like 20 hours a week, you will be able to manage level two in November.
Okay.
Yes, Shreya.
Yeah, thank you.
Hello.
Yes, Shreya.
Yeah, I'm so sorry. There was a glitch. So I actually wanted to ask the same question that is it possible like to prepare for level two in 7-8 months while working and then clear it?
It's possible. But if you believe you have a doubt, then go for level two February. I mean, delay it for 3 months if you believe you have a doubt. But I believe it's possible. Like you have, either you can start preparation right now only, or if you want to wait for the result, then you have April, May, June, July, August, September, October. So you have 7 clear months to prepare for your level 2 exam. So it's possible.
Okay. So if you give your November level 2, then your level 3 would be in the month of May.
Okay. If you level 2 February, your level 3 would be in the month of November.
November. Okay.
Yes, Dishan.
So this 20 questions are for this exam also, right? Like we gave the exam we gave. For this MPI.
The exam was out of 160 marks. It was not out of 180 marks because the 20 questions were time pass questions. And you don't know which were those time pass questions.
Exactly. So, sir, that 20 questions, they'll remove easy and they'll remove difficult.
No clue about it, Dishan. So, we can't discuss about it because we have no clue which 20 questions were those. So,
okay,
it is their policy. I don't know. I don't agree with that policy, but it is their policy to not evaluate 20 questions. They randomly planted 20 questions just to annoy you.
And also, so I wanted your guidance for like placement and something. So I'll talk that person, right?
We'll discuss that in person.
Okay.
So you told around 110 would be the passing. So is it out of 180 or 160?
It was out of 180. So if it is out of 160, then the passing rate would be somewhere around 95, 96. 95, 96 would be the passing score.
Okay, then it's
you don't know like which 20 questions were there. So for you, you attempted 180 questions. So I'm thinking after 180, if you're getting somewhere around 110, you'll surely pass.
Basically around 60%. Around
60%,
yeah.
Okay. Sir, can you share the soft copy of the question bank for level 2?
I'll do that. Question bank as well as the notes, I'll send it to you in the
group. Yeah, thank you, sir.
Yes, Dimple.
So as you have mentioned regarding the NCFM courses, so could you just share the
links? I'll share the links.
Yeah. Share the link. Thank you. Okay.
Yes, Nachiket. I think done. Nachiket question was done. Nachiket, can you lower hand if it is done? Or you have another question? Yeah, Nachiket.
No, sir. I don't have a question.
Fine, guys. I think we are done. I don't think so. Any doubts are pending? Yes, Sarvesh, you have a doubt pending? Raise hand, Sarvesh, if you have a doubt pending. Do you have a doubt, Sarvesh? Yes, Sarvesh, go on. I'm sorry. Yes, Sarvesh, go on. Yes, Sarvesh. No, it won't be. Sarvesh is asking, will the minimum passing code be higher? Right. No, why will it be? It will be same. I think they would be even more considerate with you, I believe, like they were with the December guys. December guys' ka minimum passing score was lower down. The passing rate was higher than normal. It was around 55% passing rate. So I believe they could be even considerate with you rather than being harsh on you. So they will not increase the, they will not reduce the passing rate. They may increase the passing rate, which means that a minimum passing score can even go down. I don't think so that they're going to be harsh on you. Yes, Achi.
Sir, I wanted to ask that I wanted to do a master's or an MBA, but do you think an MSc in finance would make sense with CFA, or MBA would be a better option?
Good. MBA gives you, MBA costs you more, and MBA teaches you soft skills, which are actually given more value in the job market as compared to the financial skills. So financial skills along with the soft skills which you learn in the MBA course are considered to be more valuable. So the package that you get from an MBA course is slightly more as compared to the package that you get from a MS finance course. So I'm talking about you, the worldwide guys, I'm saying. So MS finance course is a low risk, low return kind of investment. Risk is lower because the investment that you will be making would be lower. MS Finance is a cheaper course, but the package will also be slightly lower. MBA Finance is an expensive course, but the package that you will get will be also higher.
But do you think MBA would make more sense?
But yeah, you're right. CF and MS Finance have a lot of overlap, but just because it is overlapping, you should not do MS Finance. If you have like a budget, and if you are okay with spending that much of amount for MBA, then you should go for MBA Finance rather than MS Finance.
Okay.
Yes, Achigan.
So now that they've increased the frequency of the exams, do you think that they'll reduce the pass rate for level 2? And
they will not. They will not reduce the passing rate, because I don't expect the registrations will go out, will increase substantially. I don't think so. But if it happens, they'll watch it across, and then they will subsequently reduce the passing rate later on, not really for the February exam at all. February exam itself is a big success for CFA. They will not want to hamper the chances of lesser registrations for level 2 by killing on the passing rate. So they would want many students to register for level 2. So they will not hamper their chances of getting lesser, their chance of getting a good registration for level 2. So they will not reduce the passing rate for level 1.
No, sir. I'm asking the passing rate for level 2 and 3.
That will depend. That will depend subsequently. So right at this point, I can say that it depends on how many registrations that I'm going to get, because they're conducting level 2 four times a year. So it completely depends on the registration that I will get for the level 2 May, August, November, February exam. If there are a lot of registrations, then yes, they will do that.
Okay. Okay, sir.
Sanket, I don't get your doubt. Have you put it in the Q&A? Pooja, no, you should not do financial modeling course on the any institute. And you, for financial modeling, the videos that I have put on the YouTube should be good enough. And I will have more sessions for the financial modeling. So for financial modeling, do not join any institute. Results come in percentage or percentile. I'll show you one dummy result. You'll get to know how does the result come. So it comes in percentage also and percentile also. Okay. So it comes in both format. I'll show you like previous results. One, the result by masking the name, I'll show it to you. How does it come? All right. That's it for the day, guys. Enjoy your holiday and do the things like I just mentioned across it. And in case you need any help, feel free to reach out to me. Take care, guys. Good night.